this afternoon, oh God. We ask for every grace to be made available to her, every favor, yeah, God. Yeah. We thank you for what you're doing even then. But for now, God, we thank you for what you're doing in this service. We thank you for an anointed word, God, that will challenge us, encourage us, convict us, rebuke us, whatever you want to do with us, oh God. We're here for you. We're here to celebrate you, to honor you, and to lift up your name, God. So we give you thanks. We give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Glory to your name, God. Thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, it's not playing. Thank you, Father. All right. All right. That's all right. Hallelujah. It's my sound, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you. My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
The Lord, you reign above every name. My God reigns.
And our God
reigns. Oh Lord, you reign above every name. With power and majesty, dominion and authority, you reign. With power and majesty, dominion and authority, you reign. My God reigns,
and our God reigns,
the Lord, you reign above every name. My God reigns,
our God reigns,
Lord, you reign above every name. With power and majesty, dominion, authority, you reign.
Oh,
Thank you. nobody like you, Jesus.
Somebody say, our God is awesome.
Our God is awesome.
I need to repent over here this morning. My daughter's dog wanted to wake me up early in the morning. So I said, I'm going to take him out and wear his butt out. That joker, I don't know what's up with him. So he ran on that field kind of bad. I tried to tear him up this morning. Hey, man, waking me up. You want to wake me up? Get me on my way. And that's how you got to be with the devil. Where the devil? I'm not calling the dog the devil, but you want to mess with me? Come on, you want to come in here? I tell you what, I'm going to wear you out in the word. I'm going to wear you out with prayer. I wish somebody could hear me. I'm going to wear you out in worship. You'll come up in my house, knocking on my door and my bedroom, thinking you're going to create havoc. I got word for you. I serve LL, y'all, the most high God. He has the final authority and the final say. So when sickness come knocking at the door, you say, get up out of here. Come on. You ain't got to welcome it. Come on, somebody. Hold on. When poverty come knocking on the door, get up out of here. Come on. Remember what Jesus said to say, get ye out of here. Get ye behind me. Come on. Right. You better put poverty and sickness behind you this morning. Right. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus. Thank Spirit of heaviness come, get ye behind me. Come on. Glory to God. Put Satan, matter of fact, not get ye, get up under my feet. Glory be to God. I come to tell you, my God, ain't nothing the devil can do to a believer who walks in his or her God-given authority. I wish somebody was here this morning. I come to tell you, there's authority of the believer. Praise God. And we've been commissioned. We've been commissioned. I said we've been commissioned with what? Power. He didn't just tell us to go, but he told us to go in power. All power has been given to me in heaven. Come on. And earth. Well, what are you talking about on earth? Talking about you and I, praise God. Holy Ghost up in you. Come on, I come to tell you it ain't over till, why, not when the fat ladies sing. Come on. Now the fat ladies can't sing anyway, so it's over soon they start singing. Amen. I don't know where that come from. We just say anything. Nah, it ain't over till God says it's over. Though a righteous man falls seven times, he shall get up again. Come on, glory be to God. Don't rejoice over me yet, thy enemy, though I fall. I will arise, glory to God. It ain't in the fall, it's in the rise. I'm telling you right now, because when you get back up, I'm telling you now, you're getting up better than you went down. I wish somebody can hear me, my God.
Yes.
You're going to learn what caused you to go down, so I ain't going down that road no more. Come on, I come to tell you, get ready. I prophesied, glory to God, to wherever you are right now, that your best days are ahead of you. They are not behind you, and I don't care what your body is saying. I don't care what your bank account is saying. I don't care what even you say. I come against the doubting mind, and I release the word of God to change even your mind. You who are doubting the word this morning, I come and say, you'll doubt no more. Glory to God, because you can't speak to a mountain with doubt in your heart, but you must speak to that mountain without doubt in your heart, and it must be removed.
Must be removed.
I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but I'm telling you right now, this is a great time to be serving Christ. Glory be to God. I'm telling you right now, when all hope is lost, I mean, no, we are the children of hope. Your name ain't got to be Hope Lattimore. Yeah, come on. You hope. Glory to God of the kingdom. Praise God. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Your hope will get you more. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said your hope will get you more, because your hope is your expectation. Ain't nobody here.
Amen.
I'm not hearing me. The Bible says hope does not disappoint.
That's right.
Oh, glory to God. For the love of God has been shed abroad in your heart by the Holy Ghost. I come to tell you, you can't lose with the stuff we use if you use him. Come on, you got to allow him to come out of you, and you got to allow him to come above you. Man, you ain't playing. I ain't playing with you.
Amen, amen.
Come on, we talked about persevering last week. I'm still stuck on that. Come on, glory to God. Because I'm telling you right now, there's a reward for you making it. Hello, somebody. But there's never a reward for you throwing the towel and giving up. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Glory be to God. So I'm going to stay right on them. I gave you some keys to persevering last week, but I'm going to give you some more today. Amen?
Amen.
Luke 16 and 10. I'm just going to piggyback right where I was. I'm not even going to review, because the review will get me stuck. Because what I gave you last week wasn't even my message. It was what the Holy Ghost gave me fresh off the press.
Amen.
I handled it. My wife told y'all, he changed the message. Amen. So I'm going to try to stick with some of the notes that I had. Amen. But I don't know if I'm going to make it through this, because he's already speaking even right now. So we want to talk about persevering. And we know perseverance means sticking power. It means going forth no matter how hard the challenge is. Come on, glory to God. So you got to take a licking and keep on sticking Amen, okay. Somebody. Glory be to God. Stick to the plan. Stick to the vision. Come on, stick to the word. God gave Joseph a word, and all hell came to try to steal that word. In other words, God spoke to him through a dream. He had to hold on to the dream. You got to hold on to your dream. Hold on to your vision. Come on, glory to God. Amen. It's going to come with challenges because the enemy ain't going to just let you write your book. Ain't nobody here.
All right.
He's going to let you launch your ministry. Come on. He's going to come with challenges, but that's okay because God won't put more on you than you can bear. I'm trying to help somebody today. Amen. Amen. If you quit, all those people connected to you are done. Amen. You got to keep moving. You got to keep going forward. Glory to God. You got to keep on. Come on. It ain't over. Come on, women. You okay? Because you got knocked down in the first round and knocked down in the second round. I come to tell you now, man, we're going 10 rounds. Praise
God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I shed it about something. So if you want to persevere, amen. The first thing, well, not the first, about the 10th thing. I don't know how many I gave last. You got to keep on. Somebody said, got to keep on.
Got to keep on.
Luke 16:10. I'm talking what I'm talking about. You got to keep on. See, you got to keep moving. You got to keep going forward. You got to keep on. You got to keep on. Amen. When I got up this morning, I heard the Holy Spirit. He said, first he said, I was going to walk an hour. And then he said, now take the dog home. I said, okay, now what? Now walk another. I heard him say, keep on. You're not hearing me. How you hear? He said, keep on. And then I heard him say, and then my bishop called, I'm going to ride 10 miles a day. And then I heard the Holy Ghost say, you're going to do 10 miles a day. So I had to keep on because I knew I had church. So I got 6.2 in. Or you hear him? I got 3.8 to go. I got to keep on. Why? Because the goal is 10 miles minimum. Ain't nobody hearing me. And so I don't know what your vision is that God gave you and what the goal is. But you got to keep on. Keep on what? Going when you don't feel like, oh, my God. They used to sing a song like this. I feel like going. Come on, help me. Help. Oh, I feel, come on.
Feel like going on.
It goes something like this. Though trials may come, my God.
Though trials come on every hand, I feel like going on.
One more time. I feel like, come on.
I feel like going on.
Come on, anybody gonna keep on this morning? Come on.
I feel like going on.
Tell the devil, I'm going on. Ain't nothing you can do.
Oh, trials come on every hand. I feel like going on.
Glory be to God. And sometimes you gotta just get in there and say, I'm more than able. See, that's what Cain, come on, that's what Joshua and Caleb said. I know they said, we are able. They said, we are going on. That's what able means. We are going on, not feel, but we are going on. Praise God. Because God who begun this work shall complete. All he needs to do is keep on going on. Amen. Luke 16:10 says, he who is faithful in the very little thing is faithful also in much. We out here talking about we want more. And God says, you got to persevere through this little here first.
Right.
You got to get through this little thing here before I give you more. Mm. I can't give you more right now because you can't handle it.
All right.
You ain't proved to be faithful. Come on, you keep quitting. Come on, that's another word for perseverance, being faithful. Amen. Amen. So,
yes.
So the you got to have perseverance and faithfulness.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody, amen. I mean, what a word right there. Watch this. And here's a principle. You got to persevere in faithfulness. What do I mean by that? You can be faithful for a day, faithful for a day, faithful for 2 days, but no, you got to be faithful. Mm-hmm. You got to persevere in being faithful.
Yes.
What does that mean? No matter what I start, I'm going to finish. Y'all not hearing me.
Amen.
No matter what I'm doing, I'm going to keep doing it.
Till
so you got to learn how to persevere in faithfulness. You know, you got to persevere in love. I can change this message all the way around. There's a lot of things you got to keep on going and stick to. But one, if you're going to do anything for God, the Bible says this, that without faith, it's impossible to please God. And he who comes to him must believe that he is a rewarder. What? Those who diligently, what? Seek him. Those who, watch this, continue to seek God no matter what they're going through.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And so a key here, amen, to perseverance, is you got to keep on, and that's the perseverance of faithfulness. Amen. You got to stay faithful to, watch this here, to preserve in daily challenges. You got to keep going. Amen. Or in other words, you got to persevere. I'm sorry, you got to stay faithful to persevere in daily challenges. Amen. So you're going to have daily challenges on the road. The devil is not going to sit there and smooth out the road for you. He's going to try to put every bump in the road, everything he can to distract you, to discourage you. But you got to say, this is just a bump in the road. You, it's just a speed bump. You know, a speed bump don't mean turn around. It is a speed bump. Slow down. Take your time. Go over it. Come on, somebody. Praise God. And then guess what? Here come another. Hey, guess what? No problem. But it don't mean you stay the course.
Amen.
Ride the speed bumps. You just slow down.
Yes.
Amen. The devil ain't going to hand you no Gatorade to finish your race. Come on. Stop thinking the devil going to bring you Gatorade.
Amen.
Amen. And if he does bring it so hot, it's going to burn your mouth anyway. I don't think why.
Don't drink it.
So you got to stay faithful to persevere in daily challenges. Because, you know, when you have a vision from God, it don't happen overnight. So now to get there, amen. Remember, there's some steps that the steps of a good man, woman is ordered by God. So there's going to be some daily things you need to do, some weekly things you need to do, some monthly things you need to do. So you got to watch this. You got to stay faithful to persevere in the daily challenges. That's where most people throw the towel in.
Right.
Because here it is. God gives you a word. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. And here's the thing. See, it's already done in heaven. But for it to manifest on earth, it takes time. And that's where the Bible says, add to your faith patience. Come on, glory to God. Come on, you got to hang in. You got to stay the course. Don't give up on the daily challenges. Yes, the enemy going to come not once a week, not twice a week. Somebody going to come every day. But guess what? Stay persevering through the daily challenges.
Good work.
Anybody have some daily challenges this week?
Amen.
Anybody have some challenges this week? The devil don't just necessarily challenge you on Sunday and Saturday or the days of worship.
Amen.
Come on. He challenges some of you this morning. Amen. Amen. Last night. Come on. Amen. Matter of fact, trying to challenge you why service going on. But you got on the window pane. Yes. When you struggle to have hope, cling to him anyway. There's times when you, okay, somebody said, preach, black man. That's what I'm going to do because that's all I know to do. Amen. Hey, why does it write this down? When you struggle to have hope, because there's times you struggle to have hope, man, you want to just give up, but you got to cling anyway. Stick to the plan, stick to the word. What did God say? Come on, somebody, keep on moving. You got to just hang in there. Absolutely. You never run track. You ain't just run track on a sunny day. There was times where it was 120 to 105 degrees, or it was raining. When I ran cross country, they ain't called a match off because it rained.
Amen.
And I had to run in the rain, slipping and sliding, hooking and crooking. Amen, somebody. Hallelujah. Cheating like crazy, man. I said, you know what? I found this one track I figured out. I'm going to hide over here because you had to do it three times. There ain't no. Came around there fresh like I did something. Amen.
Bless the Lord.
But you ain't got to do that in this race. Come on. You got to run the race. Come on, somebody that's set before you, and you got to run it the right way. Don't quit. Don't give up. So you can't struggle to have hope. When you struggle to have hope, playing to him anyway. All right. When your plan isn't working, when the ministry ain't going the way you said, when nobody gave to help you with the budget, ain't nobody hear me right now. When the people said they were going to show up, don't show up. You got to go with it anyway.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, you got to stick to it. Come on. You got to trust God anyway. When you're trying to save to get a house and it looked like, good Lord, every day there's a challenge to take your little savings money. You got to stick to it anyway. Anybody ever been there? The devil ain't going to let you there and own no property.
Amen.
You gotta stick there anyway, you know what I'm telling you? Okay, since you want to take this money, I'm going to double up my now. I'm going to double this money up here. And he leave me alone now because I told him that don't work with me. Amen. So when your plan isn't working, when the ministry ain't going the way it said, when the book ain't going the way you thought it should go, ain't nobody hear me. After you write the book and they ain't buying it the way you thought, you stick to it because God says, I ain't done yet. See, sometimes he'll sit back to see what you're going to do. When Jesus told them folks, he said, the day going to come when you're going to eat of my flesh. Them jokers said, out of here. Not today, Jack.
Not today.
Oh, you hear me? I'm going to Burger King. They went to Burger King. And some went to McDonald's. And some went to Kentucky Fried Chicken. Oh, you hear me? But Jesus stayed the course. He didn't say, well, they all left me. Come on, in ministry, some of your most faithful people, they'll be here and then they could leave. Guess what? Don't you lose no sleep over that. You stick to the plan. Because remember, when God gave you the vision, they wasn't there anyway. Mm. He gave it to you.
All right, man.
Anybody ever been there? And you out here, why are you trying to make them come back if they don't want to be there? Remember, you started without them and thank them for the time that they helped you, but you got to keep on trucking. Oh, my God. See, you got to keep on keeping on. See, you got to be faithful. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody say glory to God. Glory, say, glory to God. You got to have perseverance and faithfulness.
Amen.
Yes.
That's going to be one of the keys, man, to you being able to persevere. Because that's when all hell breaks loose. We lose our faithfulness. We give up and we throw the towel in. Now, I'm persevering this morning in what? Faithfulness. Somebody said, I'm going to keep on keeping on. Somebody say, keep on keeping on. They said they're going to help me at 8 o'clock. Here it is, 10 o'clock. You know what? Go ahead on without us. God is sending somebody. Come on. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, we still on keeping on. When you are weary, you got to rest in him anyway. You got to learn how to just fall in his presence. And then sometimes learn how to just chill, get away. Come on, so you can come back stronger. Ain't nobody hearing me, huh? Yes. You got to do what Jesus did. You got to go to the other side. That'll help you stay faithful. See, when you get weary, that's the first thing you want to do is what? You want to quit. Oh, you hear me? But now, when you get weary, man, he give rest to the weary. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. You just got to learn how to be faithful now, get into his presence. Come on, get to prayer. And just chill in him. Somebody say chill in him.
Chill in him.
We chill everywhere else, but we don't know how to chill in him. Ain't nothing like me and my dad was talking this morning. He said, I talked to one of my young prophets. He liked to run and all that. I told him, you got to start taking walks like me and Apostle Devin. And he told him, he said, man, when you walk, you can hear God. You can clear your mind. You're getting exercise. You can pray. Come on. It's hard to be running and praying because you can't breathe. And you know what I mean? And it's just like, it's no rest there. So I went out for an hour and I heard the Holy Ghost said, do another 2 hours, man. But I feel good. I'm alive. But I heard God. Are you hearing me? And then he just confirmed, come on, somebody. And remember, I said I was going to do 1 hour. Then the Holy Spirit said, do another hour. And then he said, after service, do another 2 hours. Y'all better hear me. Oh, my God. And then he might change his mind, but I doubt it. So you got to persevere in faithfulness. Uh-oh. Now, you know my favorite scripture is Luke 18 about that persistent widow. You got to persevere. You got to have perseverance in prayer. You can't just pray. Mary had a little lamb, and you know, little lamb had Mary. You know what I'm saying? Man, you got to pray without ceasing, the Bible says. Come on. Men ought to always pray. Glory to God. Amen. Let's look at Luke 18 and 3. Matter of fact, go to Luke 18 and 1. Mary had a little lamb, and little lamb had Mary. Amen. I love me some lamb, but come on, man. You got to pray more than that. Huh? Got to be persistent in prayer. And you know the hardest time to pray for children of God, not, I ain't talking about grown up, mature Christians, when you're going through something, when you're weary, because you give up hope, hope in prayer, hope in the word. See, when you lose hope, nah, man, when it looks like you're losing hope, come on, you got to hang in there, y'all.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen. Luke 18:1. It says, then Jesus told his disciples a parable to show them that they should, that men ought to always pray and not to give up, lose hope, or get discouraged. Now, let me help you. Men ought to always pray so they don't lose hope, faint, and one try they faint. Now, you know what caused somebody to faint? No oxygen, no air. Amen. Now, when you pray as a believer, it's the breath of God. Y'all not hearing me. Or it's breathing. Prayer is equivalent to breathing. So when you don't pray, watch it, you're not breathing. What happened? Now you get weak and you faint. But here's the other thing. When you continue to pray, the devil faints. You're not hearing. Because prayer, if you read this in the Amplified as it go on, I ain't going to read the whole parable. She railed on. Come on, somebody. She strangled the enemy. See, when you don't pray, you get strangled. But when you do pray, y'all not. When you don't pray, the enemy strangle you. But when you do pray, you know what? Let me read this in Amplified. Cause y'all think I'm playing around here. let me get this. Cause I ain't got time to be playing games this morning. Just hold on, hold on, hold on. Let me get my new translations out. I got every translation here. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody said hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
my wife got to get it. Now, how about my Bible don't want to load? And that devil, but he don't know. Watch this. I'm going to stay patient. I'm going to be faithful. I'm going to persevere because now it's loading. I'm just going to wait. I'm going to wait on God. He think he's sick. Amen. Hallelujah. Get that amplified, sweetheart. Matter of fact, I'm going to show how dumb the devil is. One of y'all already got the amplified. Read the amplified. Luke 18. Come on, read it. I'll tell you when to stop. Can you read it a little louder, whoever read it? All right, never mind. I got it. I got it. Took too long. I got it. I got it. Now, Jesus was telling the disciples a parable to make a point that at all times they ought to pray and not give up, lose heart, saying in a certain city there was a judge who feared God, had no respect for man. Here's my verse I'm going to. There was a desperate widow in the city, and somebody said she kept coming. Well, she kept, I could have made that point one, keeping on. She kept coming. Somebody said she kept coming. To him saying, give me justice and legal protection from my adversary. And for a time he would not, but later he said to himself, even though I do not fear God nor have respect for man, yet because this widow continues to bother me, prayer bothers the enemy. Prayer troubles the enemy. Y'all not, the prayer of faith tears the enemy up.
Amen.
No, she wasn't talking about his mama, and she wasn't throwing sticks. All she was doing is prayer, and he quivered at that till she was bothering me. Oh, my God. Amen. Wow. See, when you don't pray, the devil bothers you. But when you do pray, you bother the devil. I wish somebody could hear me. Amen. And she says, give me justice and legal protection. And for a time, he would not. Even though I do not fear God nor respect man yet, because she continues to bother me, I would give her justice and legal protection. Otherwise, by continually, she will be an intolerant annoyance. Come on. An intolerable annoyance, and she will wear me out.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
I'm in the amplifier. The Lord said, listen to what the unjust said. Oh, yeah, in other words, prayer wears out the enemy. Mm-hmm. One trance, they say it rails on. You ever see a boxer just giving them body blows? As you keep praying and keep coming, you give me body blows. And eventually, amen, he going down. Can't keep taking them blows. So you got to continue to pray. You got to knock and keep on knocking. Seek and keep on seeking. Y'all not hearing me. Glory to God. Because eventually, one of them knocks, he's coming down. I ain't hearing him. I'm going to wear him out. And notice what he says. Her continuing prayer is bothering me. It's an intolerable annoyance. You ever see them little things they make to get mice and insects out your house? They make a sound that they can't handle. Y'all not hearing me. Glory to God. And so that sound pierces the ear. And so prayer pierces the ear of the enemy. And the frequency of prayer is too strong. Y'all not hearing me. And it wears him out. And it busts him up. And it strangles him. And it rails on him. In other words, it takes the life out. And now he, amen. You got to bind the strong man. Oh, you hear me? And once you bind him, then you can go get your stuff. And that's what prayer does. Come on, he loses his power and you gain power. Y'all not here. Then you go back in it. And then he'll say, you ain't even got to take it. He say, here. That's what it said there. Here. Give her what she wants. Give the people what they want. Give the Christians what they want. See, the demons start saying, boom, boom. Give the Christians what they want. Come on.
Thank you,
Lord. Amen. The prayer of faith. I'm talking about the prayer of faith. Somebody said the prayer of faith.
Prayer of faith.
Come on. And so verse 3, it says she kept coming to him. So I'm talking about persevering in prayer. That means you keep on praying. You pray without ceasing. Come on, praise God. You keep on praying the prayer of faith. You keep on praying the word. Come on. You got to push, pray until something happens. What happened? What God said was going to happen. You got to pray. I'm tired of us praying and not seeing what we prayed for. But when do I stop praying? When I see what I prayed for, then I start praising. My God, hallelujah.
All right.
So she kept on. So we got to persevere in prayer. Amen. Persistent faith keeps asking. Come on. Somebody say, I got to keep asking. It keeps coming. It has tenacity despite prolonged difficulties. Oh, my God. I said persistent faith keeps asking. You got to stay persistent in your faith.
Amen.
Amen.
That woman just kept asking, and she ain't asked for 100 things. Protection from my adversaries. Justice from my adversaries. Y'all not hearing me. That's what God, and then he said, give her what you, even though he hated God, had no regard for God or the people of God or people, It don't matter. The hardest person's heart can get turned in prayer.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen. Amen. So you got to keep on praying, believing that God will answer. Remember Mark 11, pray, believing that you're going to receive.
Yes.
Got to keep on saying. Come on, you got to keep on saying. You got to keep on saying. Having the same spirit of faith that says, come on, what his mouth, what it believes in his heart.
Right.
Paul said, and corrected. Amen. And watch this here. Being persistent is a choice. You got to make a decision to be persistent. It's not going to happen automatically. I make a decision that I'm going to be persistent. Come on, somebody, in my faith or the prayer of faith.
Amen.
Oh, my God. Come on. What are you believing God for? Stay in there. Stay in there. Yeah, difficulty's going to come. That's when you got to stay in there. And you got to keep asking. And don't let nobody tell you if you ask more than once, you're not in faith. Because even Jesus says, knock and keep knocking.
Mm-hmm.
Seek and keep seeking. Ask and keep asking. Well, I thought if I asked more. No. The Bible says don't be weary and well doing. Asking and keep asking is you being persistent in your faith. And watch this here. Ain't no way in the world a devil or a demon or a pastor should tell you if you ask more than once, you're not in faith. Tell them they don't know nothing about faith.
Because
even Jesus said something more than once. He said, again, I say. Come on, I'm tired of that. You better read the Bible. That's why I don't let these religious demons and devils behind the pulpit or whatever tell me. I know what the word says. So you can come all incorrect with me. I'm going to put you back in the word. Huh? You better know who you playing with. Are you hearing me? I know the word. Are you hearing me? And I know it works. I watched it work. When we believe God to put our kids to school, when we believe our God to go to school, when we believe God when we were miles away from them to keep them, glory to God, and to come down and come back with their education, not a baby and a boyfriend. You better hear me, because most people go to college, they don't finish.
Amen.
So we prayed them in, praying them through, and now still praying for them. Why? Because prayer still works. My God, I wish somebody could hear me. Maybe if you'd have kept on praying instead of complaining or letting them quit. Come on now, you hang in there.
Yes.
I remember Bree first year, she wanted to come home. You ain't coming here, you got to hang in there. If you come here, you're going to another college. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Was that your freshman year? I don't remember one of them years. I can't remember. She said all my years. My bad. I forgot. She like I tell my wife, look, can't be no baby with it. Come on. Cause that thing real. They call that sickness, homesickness. Mm-hmm. You know that girl, we spoiled these kids, they remember home shoes. This meal nasty. Dad cooked better than it. You know what I'm saying? So come on. But we had to train them. Hey, nah, hang in there. You ain't going way down there to quit.
Amen.
And she has some rude professors and people mistreating her. Nah, you staying in there. And then write them back. And she did that and things changed. Come on. Somebody say amen. Amen. But you ain't looking. And I'm not saying they're not going to have setbacks. They will. I had some. Everybody on this screen who went to college had setbacks. I came home my sophomore year. Then my dad said, well, you ready to work full time? I said, no, I'm going back. Cause you know what I mean? Because he basically told me, if you quit here, you're going to work full time. And I said, no, well, I tell you what, I'm going back and apologize to the coach and I'm finished school. And I did. Oh, yeah. And you got to have them kind of coaches. Everybody will have setback and challenges. That ain't what crushes you. But when you meet them, get to them, fight them, meet them, and win them, conquer them. Amen. Somebody say, don't just throw the towel in because you had a setback. Come on. Everybody on here had a class or something. I had to go to summer school one year. And really, it wasn't even my fault. My advisor made me take the wrong classes that didn't count in my major.
Oh, wow.
What are you talking about, going to jail in college? I had a decision. Do I go to jail or do I finish college?
Uh-oh.
Oh, I'm ready choking, man, because, you know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, you know, in that last year, you ready graduate, all your friends graduating. I had to wait a semester. You know what I'm saying? And not because I couldn't do the work, because of somebody else. But how many know I had to persevere? I had to persevere. Ain't nobody here, but I had to persevere. And I had to watch them graduate.
The word.
That hurt, man. That joint hurt. You know what I mean? I said, that hurt, man, but I got out of there. Come on, somebody said, I got out of there. And my kids, I said, y'all ain't the only ones who graduated with honors. I graduated with honors too. They said, no, you didn't, Dad. I said, it was an honor to graduate.
Amen.
Amen.
I had all that Kumali and Boo La La. I don't even know how to say all that stuff. But I know I said I was going to start and I was going to finish, because everybody in my family who started college back then would start and nobody finished. Me and my twin brother were the first two to finish. I'm talking about in my whole family. Come on, are you hearing me? But guess what? It wasn't easy. I didn't say I didn't want to quit. As a matter of fact, I tried. But I had a dad, I had a coach, just like you got an apostle. I ain't gonna let you quit. Come on, sometimes you need a tough coach. Sometimes you need a pusher. Come on, to give you that push when you just don't want to go. Are you hearing me? Man, some of you, I see it right now. You sprain your ankle on the 10-yard line. You got 10 yards to go. Guess what? Crawl in. Are you hearing me?
Come on.
You're going through today, amen? You're going to live through. You better hear James Brown. Well, get on the good foot. You just can't say I ain't going in there because my right foot hurt. Then get on the left foot. Then go with it. Are you hearing me? I left them behind and I finished. You'll catch that later on. Come on. So persistence, amen, and perseverance, it's a choice. You got to make a decision. Amen. And so I need to, that's me. I'm sorry. I'm banging in the dog like persistently. He want to bark because he thinks somebody knocking.
Amen.
So I'm preaching and I'm knocking. He didn't bark. Matter of fact, I like set me more. So anyway. So you got to persevere in prayer. Here's the next thing you got to persevere in. I keep hearing Apostle Mick on this. Galatians 6 and 9. Let's go there. Amen. This reminds me of the 76ers. That's why I'm going to talk to Mick on this one. Remember, the Sixers kept saying the process, the process. Man, to get to where they are now, to have the best team in the East, they went through a lot. Man, they were the talk of the NBA. They were the joke of the NBA. So write this down. You got the perseverance of process. Mm-hmm. Amen. But they had to go through a lot to get where they are now. But they had a plan. And ain't nobody agree with it, but they had a plan. They stuck with it, whether people believe it or not. And now it paid off. They're the top team in the Eastern Conference. Right. And it started, though, with a process. Somebody said process. Stuff don't happen overnight, is what I'm saying. Come on. Man, you know, and you want to hear something else? Nobody want to even be processed anymore. Nobody ever want to be matured anymore. Everybody just want to preach one word and just be in there. Nah, man, you got to be processed.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Said, Galatians 6, 9, let us not lose heart and doing good. For in due time, we will reap if we what? Do not grow weary. So it's a process. Stay faithful. Persevere in the process. It ain't going to always happen overnight. It ain't happen overnight for Joseph, who I talked about last week. It didn't happen overnight for Paul. Come on. It didn't happen overnight for Jesus, even though it was a quick 3 years, but it didn't happen overnight. Oh, you hear me? So you got to be processed. Come on, somebody. And you got to, watch this. You got to persevere through the process because it's in God's timing, not yours. Amen. Now, can I just say this to you? You out here believing God for something big. Now I'm ready to bust you. Well, that's how big your process and long it may be. The bigger the thing God has for you, the bigger the process. So you got to stay faithful. You got to persevere through the process. Are you hearing me? What it took for Joseph to get to the pit, to the palace, wasn't an overnight journey. Come on. Y'all know the story. His brothers tried to kill him. Come on. Then Reuben had to come and bail it. Nah, let's not kill him. Come on, then he was thrown in a cistern, but watch it, it got empty. Y'all not hearing me? Come on. And then he got sold to some slave traders. Come on. Then he ended up in Potiphar's house. Then his wife lied on him. He ended up in prison. Somebody say that's the process.
That's the process.
And really, watch this here. How many know favor in prison wouldn't have been good enough? He could have settled there and said, look, I'm second in charge of the prison. Watch this here. Even before that, I'm second in charge in Potiphar's house. Nah. You got to stay faithful to the process because God wants to finish what he started. And the goal was not to be second to the warden in prison. It wasn't to be second to the chief executive. Come on. God says, nah, I want you to run the world's financial system. Come on. Glory be to God. Because ultimately, I got to put you in position and you in prison ain't going to help your family because they ain't in prison. You in Potiphar's house ain't going to help your family because they ain't in Potiphar's house. I want to position you so that you can help change and save two nations, Israel and Egypt. Y'all not hearing me. I wish I had time to go into this. Well, I'm going to leave Joseph alone because I used to preach about him every week, but I just had to mention Joseph. He wasn't really in this sermon this week. But Joseph, I love you, brother, because you held on to your dream. Come on. You know, God gives you a vision. You got to hold on. How? By keeping on. By being persistent in prayer. Come on, somebody. By persevering in the process. Come on in. Why did the dream, the vision is going to be challenged, but you just hold on. Come on, because those who hold on to the end, come on, somebody, those who endure to the end shall be saved.
Yes, yes.
So discouragement, watch this. You can't allow the spirit of discouragement to overtake you. I'm helping somebody right now because discouragement can distort, come on, somebody, and frustrate and stop division, amen, and derail or get you off track of the purpose of God.
Amen.
So discouragement, you got to deal with that, man. You can't allow discouragement to overtake you. Come on. So you got to learn how to deal with that. Come on. And that's why it says, don't be weary and well doing. You're gonna reap if you faint not. In other words, sometimes you say, but I've been doing good. You know what he told me to tell you? Keep on doing good.
Amen.
You can't get weary in doing good because we in our human nature and flesh think that every time we do something good, we should get an instant reward. You don't always get an instant reward for doing good. Y'all not here.
Yes.
Come on. Now you got to remember the process. See, I can reward you right here, says God, but that ain't the ultimate, come on, place that I appointed you. So now why would you want, come on, somebody, a elementary diploma when you can get a high school diploma? You don't want all the way through. Y'all not here. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say, God, hold on. So how many know? Write this down. God is in control of all the results. So you need to know this. So when it looked like I'm doing good and discouragement's trying to come, God's still in control. He who begun this work shall complete it. Everything is working together via, here we go, for my good. That's when you need that scripture, when it looked like you doing good, but ain't nothing working good. Amen. You better sing it anyway. Pray. Everything is working. Together, even though you mix them songs, even though I don't feel it, you work. Here I was here, everything. You start mixing all them faces. We come this far, my baby. Oh my God. You know, you better sing some word and put some scripture up there. Come on. But I'm telling you, that's what's going to keep you. Amen. The word will cause you to prevail. It will cause you to triumph. I ain't hear nobody. God is in control. Somebody say, God is in control. And God is with me. And so since God is with me, he's in control, not the devil. If God is with you, the devil can't be in control.
All right.
Amen.
Somebody say amen. And he'll also provide. Ask Abraham. Come on, when he was ready to slay Isaac. Y'all not hearing me. Glory God, there was a ram behind the bush. I come to tell you, God told me to tell you, he got rams behind the bush. Come on, but you got to keep on keeping on, even when you don't understand, even when you don't feel like it, even when it don't make sense. Faith ain't supposed to make sense. Why do you keep trying to make faith make sense? Mm-hmm. Just that he don't want it to make sense. He just wants you to trust him.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to say this here. I've said it a lot. You can't confuse not now with not ever.
All right.
Uh-oh.
All right.
Because it ain't happened now, don't mean it won't happen.
All right.
So you got to learn not to confuse the two. You can't confuse not now. Because how many know? That's why it says don't be weary and well doing. See, you want it right now. And God said, no, not now. Jesus. But I didn't say it wasn't going to happen.
Thank you, Lord.
See, God couldn't allow Joseph to get where he got to because watch this here. He had to be processed. And here it is this time when they said, this is he who can interpret a dream because he was processed through what he went through. You got to go through what you go through to process you. Come on, somebody. See, gold has to be processed. Come on. It has to go through fire. Y'all not hearing me.
Right.
And see, we want to come out gold, but we don't want the process.
Right. Right.
We want a microwave. Come on, microwave meals ain't always good. Come on.
Amen.
Better get that crock pot. Come on, boy, that rib, come out that. See, I love pulling ribs out the crock pot because I be playing, I pull up real slow. You pull up like that, ain't no meat on this side.
Ain't no meat.
Yeah. So I play games with it like. As soon as I get in, boom, it went back in. Somebody say you got a process.
Process.
Don't confuse. I'm talking to everybody. God don't always do it suddenly. Yes, we saw it in the book of Acts and suddenly, but he don't always do it suddenly. He didn't do it suddenly with Joseph. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
He didn't do it suddenly with Paul. He ain't do it suddenly with Abraham. You know how long it took Abraham? Matter of fact, he put Abraham on how many year timeout? 13? Hey, he put Abraham on a 13 year timeout where he ain't talked to him. Can you imagine that? You out here thinking you waited. I couldn't imagine God not talking to me in this crazy world we live in now. For 13 years, I've been on lost my mind. Matter of fact, I've been joining Paul doing prison ministry.
Hello, somebody.
And then here's the other thing. Here's our theme for last week. Just don't go there, but Philippians 3:14, I pressed on towards the goal.
Yes.
You got to keep pressing. Somebody say amen. So, amen. You know, what to do when you're not there yet. Not what to do when you don't know what to do. Mm. Amen. But what to do when you're not there yet. You got to keep pressing. Why? Because I ain't there yet. See, Joseph had to keep pressing. Are you in? Remember that movie, Are We There Yet? Okay, if we ain't, I got to keep pressing. Because watch this here. If you're setting out to go to California, you don't, if you're in Utah, you ain't there yet. And you black like me, you know you better get up out of Utah. I'll talk to you about that later. Somebody say amen. So what to do when you're not there yet? I know we like to say what to do when you don't know what to do. What to do when you're not there yet? What to do when you're not there yet, Callie? Gotta keep cool, gotta keep moving.
Keep on keeping on.
You gotta have a realistic view of, watch this here, of yourself. Amen. Yeah. Here's the thing. Pray for this one thing, effort. I pray this one thing, effort. I need effort because I ain't finished.
Yes.
I got one lap to go. Guess what? I gotta finish. What to do when I ain't there yet? I gotta finish that lap. Anybody hear me?
Yes. Amen. Yes.
Don't get sidetracked or watch this here. By roadblocks, what's some other thing? Speed bumps. Come on, somebody. Nah, don't get sidetracked by all that stuff, man. You gotta watch this here. You gotta just stay the course. All right? Your car ain't gonna fall that apart because you're going over speed bump. Now, if you go over 200 miles an hour, yeah, you're gonna get sidetracked and then your axle might snap. Amen. Slow down, somebody, over them speed bumps. I don't know who I'm talking to.
All right.
And you gotta remember this: past failure is in the past. Uh-oh. Past failure is in the past.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. It's no longer relevant. Come on to your situation now, because you ought to learn from it. What did I do to cause a failure? Remember?
Amen.
It ain't failure that stops us. It's our attitude towards failure. Why does God use people who fail? Because he'll have nobody to use. Every successful person failed. That's what I was trying to say when I went to college. In your journey to getting your degree, you will have some failures. You'll fail a course. Come on, somebody. You'll fail some courses. Ain't nobody hearing me.
Yeah.
Glory to God. This is crazy. Amen. U-Haul. I don't, U-Haul calling me. Amen. Now, who in the world? Why is U-Haul? I tell you what. All that baggage you got that's holding you back, put it in the U-Haul truck. Come on. Some of you got to get, I got that Holy Ghost. Some of you got, come on, all this weight that easy beset you. Come on. You, like Mick always said, you ain't finishing the race. Or you ain't going to persevere with all this stuff on you, sin and doubt and unbelief. Matter of fact, put it in a U-Haul truck right now. What's God's U-Haul truck? Cast all your cares upon me. That's right. That's his U-Haul business. It ain't called U-Haul. It's called cast your cares on me. Put it in a truck. Put it in a dump truck this morning. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And keep on going and refuse to give up. Somebody say, I refuse to give up.
I refuse to give up.
Things in the past need to take a back seat. Come on, somebody, to the challenges that are ahead. Mm-hmm. Put them some things in the past in the back seat. Come on, get them out the front seat.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Don't you hate them like other drivers? You drive and they telling you what to do. Put them in the back seat. Mm. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Put them things in the back thing, the things in the past. Somebody say amen. And then you gotta stay on track. Somebody say, gotta stay on track.
Stay on track.
Come on, ain't nothing wrong, man, worse than getting off track, getting off course. Amen.
Amen.
And Hebrews, I gave that last week, Hebrews 12:1, and let us run with endurance the race that is set, what, before us. Somebody say, run with endurance. So we got to throw off every hindrance and sin, amen, and you got to make an active decision to do so.
Mm.
Amen. Not only an active decision, a decisive action.
Uh-oh.
Let me help you again. An active decision, amen, and a decisive action, meaning, you know what? I'm changing what I'm doing. I'm changing. I ain't going down this road. I've been going down the wrong road. See, you don't just get rid of the sin. amen, by saying so. Remember, the word repent doesn't mean I'm sorry, it's a change in one's thinking. That means your action has to change.
Right. Amen.
So a hindrance can slow you down, and it makes your road more difficult. So you got to get rid of every weight. You got to get rid of every hindrance. Sometimes it's people. You got the wrong people in your circle. They slowing you down. Hello, somebody.
Go ahead.
All people in your ear. Hello, somebody. You taking your counsel from the ungodly. I don't know. Amen.
Amen.
And then you got to make sure you're doing what God called you to do, not what others prophesied told you to do. Mm-hmm. Are you running the course that God put you on? Too many people trying to be everything everybody else called them. If God ain't called you that, stick to your course. That's what God's going to anoint, and that's what he's going to crown. You cannot run in the wrong lane and get the trophy.
Uh-oh.
You're going to be disqualified. And there's so many who think they get in the crown, and at the end, God says, who told you to do that? I never called you to that.
Okay.
Stop letting people define you. You were okay doing what I called you to do.
Amen.
Wow.
Come on, man. I tell men, they prophet out. Man, no, I know what God told me. I'm locked in, y'all. I'm locked in. I know they told me. Why? Because I have a prayer life. Hello, somebody. I ain't looking for titles, positions, and prestige.
Amen.
Amen. I'm looking for results. Amen. Somebody, because at the end of the day, you can have all the titles in the world. If you ain't got no results, it don't mean nothing.
Nothing.
All right.
Nothing.
People try to call me this and call me that before my time. I said, man, no. Call me tomorrow. That's what I do. Amen. That ain't for me. I know who I am. I don't want that. That ain't what God has for me right now. No. I know how anointing works. Anointings work with appointments.
Okay. All right.
I ain't getting ahead of God. Come on, somebody. I won't get ahead of God. So I can puff me up. Because here's the other thing that comes with that. Challenges. The higher you go, more challenges. And if you ain't got the anointing for the call, you can't even handle the challenges that come with what you called yourself to.
Amen.
Somebody say process.
Process.
Preparation time is never wasted time.
Amen.
Slow down. Slow that horse down a little bit. That's what the speed bump means. Slow down. That's what they are. They don't mean don't go. They just mean slow down.
Amen.
Because God, you don't want to get to where you're going before God. Unfocused faith crushes hope. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And discouragement takes root when we become, watch this here, fixed on our problems. When we keep our minds on our problems and not the answer, that's when discouragement takes root. Now, keep your eyes on Jesus, the author and the developer of your faith. Come on.
Amen.
I wish somebody can hear me. And when you did all that, this is where I was trying to get to last week, never made it. Didn't think I was going to make it. I'm ready to stop, y'all. I'm done. I told you I ain't going to be long because I know we got a service tonight, you women. Y'all gonna be blinging, and I'm gonna be, watch this, slinging my sling, watching the NBA playoffs. Amen. Huh? I'm be slinging it. Amen. I'm gonna sit back, treat myself to some basketball today. It's been a while since I made this to kick back. I'm resting, watching me some good old, maybe I don't know how good it's gonna be. But anyway, let's close with this. James chapter 1, verse 2. Y'all know this is one of my other favorite scriptures. I know you said, man, how many favorites you got? Well, whatever one I need is working. Everyone is working for me at the time I needed to work is my favorite.
Amen.
Because they all work when you need to work if you work it right.
Amen.
If you can persevere in the word, persevere in prayer, come on, persevere in faith, it's going to work for you. So now, watch this. Why is that my favorite? Because it worked. Oh, you hear me?
Amen.
Something that works and good is always my favorite. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Sister Betty, make that sweet potato pie. It's always my favorite. Huh? What? What? I don't even eat dinner half the time. She make that pie, but I got to make room for three slices. Then I got to hope my wife is asleep in the middle of the night. You know, I sneak in the kitchen. I go in the bathroom and sneak another piece, huh? Then she wake up in the morning. Hey, what happened to the pie? You better call Roto-Rooter. We might got mice up in here.
What?
Anyway, let's close with this. Oh, Roto-Rooter the plumber, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you got to call plumber.
Okay.
Well, I got to call Roto-Rooter sneaking four pieces of that pie.
Exactly.
I see Mick over there, like, Mick want to correct me. So what that boy just said? Dad, you embarrassed me, Dad. Come on, I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry. But Roto-Rooter and Mika, you know, we have meetings. I'm Roto Rooter sometime. What in the world? Why won't this go down? Sweet potato pie. Let's close with this. Amen. James 1:2, it says, counting all joy. Watch this here. I'm ready to go somewhere. I got you, Holy Ghost. My brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds.
Yeah.
So you got to have joy. You watch it. You got to persevere in joy. Because it's the joy that's going to get you through the trials. Y'all got it.
All right.
The word count is an account, a term used by accounting. It means to count. Come on, somebody. And so I come to tell you, watch this here. When you're going through something, count it all joy. Add that to your count. Because watch it. There's going to be a reward. You might as well just start celebrating. Because on the other side of this trial, on the other side of this temptation, on the other side of this test, is promotion. Come on, somebody. And so you need to learn how to persevere in joy, not happiness. See, happiness is based on circumstances. Joy is based on my relationship with Christ. Ain't nobody hear me. And because I know God is for me, and he's not, watch it, who shall be against me? Because I know no weapon formed against me, I can have joy. Because I know that he won't put more on me than I can bear. So I don't get discouraged, because the Bible says in his presence is fullness of joy. Come on, somebody. And pleasures forevermore. And Nehemiah said, the joy of the Lord shall be my what? Strength. So now we got to learn how to persevere in being joyful. Oh, lift up your hands. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
David taught me something about this. He says, I will bless the Lord at all times. Yes. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Hell or high water, I'm going to lift up my hands. I'm going to raise up my voice. I'm going to stomp my feet. I'm going to rejoice like Jesus rejoiced in the spirit. And I'm going to count it all joy, because this too shall pass. Glory to God. If God be for me, who shall be against me? He didn't bring me this far to hang me. So, this is another opportunity for me to show off who my God is. And so I refuse to get sad. I refuse to be fearful. I refuse to be discouraged. I'm going to encourage myself in the Lord. I'm going to be joyful, for a merry heart does my body well, like medicine. Come on, somebody. So the joy of the Lord shall be mine, shall be your strength this morning. And so I'm going to persevere in joy. I'm going to say hallelujah anyhow. Come on, when it don't seem right, I'm going to throw up my hands, not throw in the towel. I'm being joyful when the doctor tells me this. I'm being joyful when the bank account look like this. See, I'm ready to help you, because you might say persevering in joy is easy. No, it ain't when the bank account ain't got what the bills is asking for. Y'all better hear me. But what do I do? Ain't no need being discouraged. It ain't going to put more money in the bank. Are you hearing me? But you better go to your joy bank. Are you hearing me? When you look at that church, that Macedonian church in strict poverty, come on, somebody, and extreme hardship, they had abundance of joy, Paul said. Come on. And that's why it says no church was like this church. That's why that church shall receive all that he had for them. Come on. What do you do when you got abundance? Watch it, a strict poverty and extreme hardship. I tell you what, they was rich in freedom. They were rich in joy. Matter of fact, let's go there real quick. Glory to be to God. 2 Corinthians chapter 8. I want. Somebody say, I got to persevere in joy.
Persevere in joy.
Come on, sir. I got to persevere in joy. Some of y'all, when you all going through something, we know it. Your attitude, you turn on everybody. Your wife just say, hey, honey, what? I just trying to tell you, age was ready. Do you know what Paul was going through, what he was going through? Philippians is his joy letter. Come on. And even in Philippians 1:12, when they put him in prison, come on, somebody, for really nothing. Come on. Watch this here. He didn't complain. He didn't cry. He wrote joy letters. Y'all not hearing me. He says, this had to happen to me for the furtherance of the gospel. Watch this here. Can you take a trial? Could you take a bad situation? This had to happen because God only could trust me with this. Come on, to bring light to this. Come on. Can God throw you in the fiery furnace? Come on, somebody, and you stay in there and say, I ain't going to bow down, even if my God don't save me. Come on, can you rejoice in the fiery furnace? Can you rejoice in the lion's den? Ain't nobody hearing me. Can you rejoice in the lion den? when people are lying on you. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. You better learn how to rejoice. Come on, because he says, I'll vindicate the righteous.
Yes.
I'll vindicate you. All you got to do is stay in joy, because joy, you being joyful in the midst of the trial, is an example that you have faith that God already worked it out. My God, ain't nobody hearing me. At midnight, Paul and Silas, they didn't get sad. They prayed and they sang hymns to God. When you joyful, watch this here, you sing to God. When you joyful, you praise in prison. Y'all not hearing me. You sing in prison. You don't cry in prison. Y'all not hearing me.
Amen.
God, where I tell you, God?
2 Corinthians.
I ain't nowhere near there. I'm drunk. I want to get there. 2 Corinthians 8. Oh, my God. It says, now, brothers and sisters, we want to tell you about the grace of God, which has been evident in the churches of Macedonia, awakening them in their longing to contribute, for during an ordeal of severe stress, their abundant joy and their deep poverty together overflowed in the wealth of their lavish generosity. Let me read that again. Awakening them and longing to contribute, for during an ordeal severe stress, distress, they had abundance of joy. Let it marinate. They didn't just have distress. They have severe distress.
Yes.
But they still said, you know what? We want to contribute to this offering to our brothers and sisters in Jerusalem.
Yes.
If giving was about money, they wouldn't have been that church. When you look in Philippians, when he says, no church, this is the church he's talking about. When we misquote that and preach it wrong, my God to supply all my need, he wasn't talking to every Christian. He wasn't talking to every church. He was talking about this church right here, the Macedonians. Let's look back in verse. He says, now, brothers and sisters, we want to tell you about the grace of God. They had a grace of giving on them. What is it? Which has been evident in the churches of Macedonia. Awaken them and longing to contribute, for during an ordeal of severe distress, their abundance of joy and their deep poverty together overflowed in the wealth of their lavish generosity. They didn't let their severe, watch this here, poverty or affliction determine their level of joy. They persevere in joy through one of the most difficult times in their history. Ain't nobody, and that's what made them a part of the history of the Bible, where no church was like this church. It separated them from everybody else. You know what will separate you from a person who goes to church to a believer? When you can count it all joy in your work situation. When you can still praise God, are you hearing me? When you can still lift your hands. When you can still say God is good all the time, even when it don't look like he good, even don't feel like he good. Too many Christians are wishy-washy, Mick. Come on. And they can only praise God when things are going well. But David taught us something. I will bless the Lord at all times.
Yeah,
his praise shall continually be in my mouth. And so we need to persevere, not only in prayer, not only in process. Come on. But we need to persevere in joy. Are you hearing me? Always got to have joy, y'all. Because Nehemiah said the joy. Everybody say the joy of the Lord.
The joy of the Lord.
Will be that power that gets me through.
That's right. That power that gets me through.
I'm done. I don't know if I bless you, mess you, but I preach to myself this morning. Oh, amen. My God. And I love it when God gives me a word for me. The first person he was preaching to was Devin A. Park. See, he turned that A that everybody else used to call me something else to Aaron, a priest. See, I didn't even know from day one Aaron represents priests. Oh, my God. Come on. Hallelujah. Somebody say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Somebody say I got to go on.
Gotta go on.
Come on, say I gotta go on.
Gotta go on.
Somebody gotta press. Somebody say I gotta press.
Press.
Hey Monette, do we got that song? I feel like going on, like the lyrics.
I can find it. Hold on. Hallelujah.
I want to hear that. Then we'll just do our communion, take her off. Yeah, I just feel like sometimes, man, we gotta. Hey, man. Hallelujah. Sometimes we gotta go back to them old songs, y'all. Because that one there is saying something. I feel like going on. I ain't singing I'm climbing the rough side of the mountain. See, when you ain't persevering singing that junk. I'm sorry. Because he never told us to climb the mountain, let alone the rough side. I don't sing, pass me not, my gentle savior. Because he said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. See, when I start getting revelation of the word, certain things, songs I took out of my arsenal because it wasn't working for me. That's like going to them drug and alcohol meetings. Either you're a new man in Christ or you still bound.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, we don't have the lyrics.
No, scratch that. We come this far by faith. I don't want to hear that anyway. We come this far by faith.
All right.
Yeah, I don't hear that anyway. I ain't trying to be funny. But I heard my song. Since I preached, see, Mick sang his song when he preached last week or Thursday. So I ain't going to sing mine. I'm going to play mine. You know what I mean? Mick can sing. I can't sing. Oh, you ought to persevere. No, you don't persevere in the things you can't do.
I can't sing. I just make noise.
Now, you saying you held that note, brother. No, I'm going to give it to you. I ain't hating. You held your note, brother. I couldn't even hold my note long enough to get it from my house to the teacher. Always lost it before it got to the teacher.
Davidson.
say hallelujah. And
hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I think I'll warm my little self out. Praise God. Let's do communion. Apostle, amen. If you do communion, my son, my brother, my I love that man. He be fighting.
Hey, we just had some church. Yeah.
That's when you know you had church. We'd be wore out. Remember when you'd be wore out after church? People said, you work today? No, I had church. Church wears you out, man. You didn't be in there all day too, but you loved it. We got back in there, went and ate some food, got some energy, came back in there, had church all over.
All day
you long. Wanted to go to bed after you ate your dessert on Sunday night, man.
Yes.
That's how I feel, man. I just feel like it don't matter what day it is, we are the church.
Amen. Amen.
I saw some of them comments. I pray that whoever that word was for, you receive it. I just know there's some things that I got to finish. Amen. I set some powerful goals. And then my wife added to it. I try to do this one thing by the end of the year. She said, no, by the end of the summer. So I got an agreement. So I tell Apostle Larry, my faith is stretched, man, because I said, I'm going to get it done. I ain't going to lie to you. It ain't happening. It with Devin, I looked at my bank account. I said, God, that's when you need faith.
Amen.
Now, by the end of the year, my bank account already made, but that ain't faith. So my wife said, no, by the end of the summer. Now, you know, in the summer, I like to have fun too now. Amen. So we eating hot dogs every night trying to make this go, but God says, no, you ain't. You'll still get your lobster. Amen. Hallelujah. Huh? Amen. So anyway, we're going to have Apostle Mick do communion, and we'll take our offering. Matter of fact, let's take our offering, because I want the last thing we do is communion. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen.
And whatever you're going to do, if you can send it in the next hour, because that's when I'm doing missions, because I know my wife got to be in. Y'all got service tonight. And amen. So if you ain't doing nothing, that's fine too. But I'm just saying if you are, you can get it in, amen, in the next hour. Don't take 4 or 5 hours to push a cash app, but you either going to do it. Oh, did I say that? You weren't supposed to hear that. I was saying that to myself. Amen. Carolyn. You ain't gonna push the button or you're not. You be sitting there like, button ain't stuck. Your finger's stuck. You need to persevere in giving. That's what that church did. They had a grace on them. It was called a grace of giving, meaning it didn't matter if they had a lot or they had a little. When you persevere through giving, that means I give whether it's convenient or inconvenient. Come on.
Amen.
It's habitual. Amen. And then God puts a grace on it. Givers can't not give. I ain't never seen this generation we have today. You get paid, don't give nothing to the church, nothing to missions. I mean, it's one thing you keep the tithe, but not $25 for missions with all the missions we doing, and you expect God to bless that? You know what I mean? I just don't understand if I never was like that and never will be. You know what I mean? God is too good. Amen. And before you know it, that job will start bringing you frustrations and a grace will come off of it. And before you know it, you ain't got one. I know a lot of people that happened to. God has let you know, okay, you want to try to do this in your own strength? Watch me. Anybody know somebody that happened to? I know every hand could be raised. Hey, it happened to me one time and I caught the message. And I actually could have, what happened was I lived around the corner from the church and we were rushing because I had work, grabbed the kids, went to Bible study on a Wednesday, right? No,
Sunday.
I mean Sunday morning. And I'm rushing. And then I was like, I'll just pay it Wednesday when I come back to Bible study. So the pastor got up there. Huh?
We forgot our checkbook.
Amen. And remember, that's back then. Wasn't no cash app and all that. We had checkbooks. That's how you paid your tithes. How many of y'all remember that? You paid your tithes with checks. And some people couldn't write checks because the church told them they weren't allowed to. We were still allowed. No, I'm serious. No, I wish I was joking, but some people, because they said no playing basketball in the church.
Right.
Bouncing stuff around. So back then, that was where they recorded and everything that helped you as well. So that's how you paid your tithes with a checkbook. So we rushed out and left for a checkbook. So I said, I'll just bring it Wednesday instead of just going home. I actually could have walked to my house and back in about 10 minutes, maybe 15 max. I mean, that's how close, but I'll just do it. Never had the intent of not paying it. So then the pastor says, some of you, didn't pay your tithes, and God gonna get that money one way or the other. Your car gonna break down. How about my car broke down, man? And it was the exact amount of my tithe. And it broke down in front of the church. I think everybody knew I ain't paid my tithe. I don't know how God deal with you, but man, I never ever played with that thing again. And not that I wasn't gonna pay it. I just said, you know, because I always gave good offering and all that. It don't matter to God. God, wait, look, he don't matter if you do it all the time. You got to keep doing it. You got to stay faithful. Come on. And I should have just went home and got it.
Amen. Amen.
What if, and then God starts speaking back. What if I just wait to bless you till Wednesday? I'm just saying, like, we just kind God. Amen. Yep. So, amen. So let's bring our tithes and our offerings, pray God. And that, thank God we don't really have that problem. Amen. But every once in a while, some of you know you get tempted to steal God's money. Don't play with it. Man, nah, just do it. Just do it. I'm telling you right now, I'd rather have the blessed 90 than the cursed 100.
All right. Good.
Somebody say amen. And then say something, sister. You on top of the world, too. Go ahead.
Okay. This week, I was going through some papers and letters. And bank envelopes. You know, this is how the Lord always blesses me. And plus, because they're going to be giving some paper shredding this tomorrow at Senior Center in Pottstown. So I said, Lord, help me get through this papers. And I didn't really want to do it, but I did it. So I had a lot of papers and envelopes tied together. So I said, okay. I went in the bedroom by the window and began to go through the envelopes. And I begin to find some money. I said, Lord, I forgot I had this money in this bag. You know what I mean? I mean, it was some money. It was some big money.
Money.
Money was coming to my house.
Yeah.
It was a miracle.
Big money.
I opened another envelope there with some more money. I mean, it was up. I have to tell you this, it was over $1,000.
Whoa.
I paid tithes on it, but money was kept coming to my envelopes. Because I said, I know it's a blessing for the Lord, because Pastor Nick had also said about the blessing we receive. So I want to let you know about, I did get a blessing this week. Mm-hmm. And also I needed to get my son's apartment, he had inspection. And I said, Lord, he doesn't want to throw anything away. So I had to go up there and try to get it in order because the inspection was Thursday. And I had to get on my hands and knees to do the rug because our vacuum, we don't have no vacuum cleaner, broke both of them. And I said, Lord, this is a hard job. So he said, get on your hands and knees. And he helped me get through the rug. And it did pass inspections. So I thank the Lord for that. So money is coming. Give beyond what you can possibly give, because even my income, they cut back on my Social Security this year already. And I said, I didn't want to get cut back on my tithing. I said, Lord, help me continue to give what I have been given, because it was like about $80 or so maybe that they took back, you know, 80, and then from the retirement, you know, so they cut back. So I was trying to continue to do what the Lord wants me to, pay my tithes in spite of the cutoff from the, you know, Social Security and stuff like that. So I'll give God glory and praise for that.
Wow. Well, amen. Well, my wife had me go buy our mailbox down here that we never check. And she had 3 checks in the mail, dated all the way back to April.
Amen.
I know what giving and tithing can do.
Yeah.
And I would have never knew that about Sister Betty, because I was just telling my wife, this woman giving more than she ever gave. See, that's now, I just said this to my wife. I said, she got something on her. She giving more than she ever gave. I would have never knew she got a cut. That's integrity, man. Like, you know what I mean? When you make that decision, you know, I know Monette Larry did that for a long time till they lost, you know, some stuff, but their ties never stopped. In other words, the amount. Mm-hmm. Amen. Matter of fact, I said it was times when Larry didn't get paid over the summer. They still sent his tithes like he still got paid. Because, you know, he gets, I guess, unemployment over the summer because he don't work. But they didn't tie it off the unemployment. They tied off the money Larry would have got. And that's why they're going to stay on top. So we go on through this covenant. You know.
Amen.
Amen. And I know the other lady shaking her head. This woman had like 2 years when she ain't working. She kept paying her tithes. Amen. She ain't got that problem now. Amen. She ready to start getting paid again. Y'all heard her testimony. Amen. For taking care of her own family. Remember, you know that's God paid you to do what you do. You've been doing for free.
Amen. Amen.
Then you can put up with a little more now when you're getting paid.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, I'm going to keep it real. You can have no attitude now, you know what I mean? You know, because, but anyway, let's go on with community. Thank you for that testimony. Praise God.
Amen.
It goes to show you that God's word is true. I didn't know that about Sister Betty.
Amen.
Amen. And I do know this. Every time she gets blessed, she sends tithes. That's why she gets blessed. She's a giver.
Amen.
Every time we say we're going to sow into Azusa, or we're going to take up an offering for the auction or the new swans, even we don't say we take up an offering, she find out somebody had a birthday. Say, hey, give me such and such a dress. Here it comes.
Yes, she does.
Amen.
That's what you call being, that's what you call persevering in your giving.
Amen.
And when you do that, you will always have seed no matter when the need comes. See, that seed go before the need. You'll always have everything you need when the need arrives. 2 Corinthians 9 says.
Yes.
Bread for food and seed to sow.
Amen. Amen.
Yes. Amen. God will cause you to be self-sufficient. And he'll make all grace abound towards you that you'll always have everything you need now and when other future needs come, the Bible says.
Yes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know, everyone get caught on the wrong side of God's giving system. Because you'll be on the bad side of the living system.
Amen.
I'm just being honest. See, when I teach that, I just give the word. And people get mad at me. Why are you mad at me? Because God says bring your tithes in. Getting all offended and mad at me. Look, I personally don't care though. Because I got to get on me if I don't teach and tell people to teach.
Amen.
Hello.
Amen.
You do what you want with it. I know what me, as for me in my house, her tithe, my tithe, going up. Oh, you hear me? Do what you want. Amen. I know what the Bible says, and that's what I do, and I don't make nobody do nothing. But thank you, Sister Betty. Praise God for that awesome testimony.
Yeah.
My wife said, check our mailbox. I ain't checked that mailbox in about a month. I'm going to check it every day now. She's got my attention this morning because we don't usually get our mail down here. Amen. Matter of fact, when church over, I'm going to check the mailbox again. Because
yeah.
The mailman didn't come yet. Bye. I mean, not one check, not two, three checks in there, Sister Betty.
Praise God.
One for the father, one for the son, one for the
oh my God, you stole that right out of my mouth. Anyway, let's do this community. That's good for somebody who needs to hear that. Stay encouraged. Hang in there. Amen. Don't fade. Don't do a fadeaway jumper. Go in the paint. Go hard in the paint. Amen.
All right.
I know you like that one, man. Yeah. All right, let's do this communion thing. Not community thing, but community. I'm drunk. I'm sorry.
We can't hear you, sir. Can't hear you.
I guess I gotta give you my preacher's voice. It's good to tithe and it's good to give offerings unto the Lord. Amen. You're not giving it to man, you're giving it to God. And just on another encouraging note, like me and my wife, we've always tithed. We've always gave. And even when you would never know if I lacked, because I wouldn't want you to know that I lack. See, and that, so you stay constant, amen. That's why I use certain words that I've learned. Stay constant in everything that you do, amen. Don't get consistent, be constant, amen. Flatline that thing out, you know, because what he tell you, the dead in Christ gonna rise. So when you flatline, you know, you ain't operating in flesh, you operating in spirit, amen. And it's a good thing to persevere, amen. There is power in perseverance. There is a price in perseverance, amen. But let me tell you something, it pays well. You will have your reward. That's what the scripture said. He will reward you. So in that, hey, don't be afraid, don't be scared. hey, I step out there and take the risk. Because if you can go down to the gambling casino and take a risk and come back with nothing, I'd rather take a kiss with God and you can come back with abundance. Amen. Amen. There is a difference. Amen. Amen. And don't slip out on church. I had that happen to me one time. I'll tell it just like it is. I went and played basketball on Sunday morning when I was supposed to have been in church, and I knew it. And you know what happened? I didn't get to play. They took me to Lackinac Hospital because I bent down to pick the ball up, and I popped my Achilles tendon. Mm. Bottom line is, I don't play with God. That woke me up tremendously. Oh, and I was in a cast for 6 months, and it took 9 months to heal. So don't play with God. I'm telling you.
I know that's right.
He ain't joking. Bless you, Sister Betty. Bless you, Pastor Carolyn. Amen. Bless y'all. Keep rolling. Amen. Because God ain't finished yet. Amen.
Amen.
Have faith in God. When we take on communion, amen, it's all about faith. It's all about believing in Him. And as we partake in our communion, trust God. It says, trust the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge Him. And He will, He shall direct thy path. He'll take you where you need to go. Amen. And as we prepare our hearts and minds for communion, let's bow our heads in a word of prayer right quick. Our Father God, we come by faith, Lord God, and we come, Lord God, believing, amen, that you are able to do exceedingly and abundantly beyond anything we ask or think of. And Lord God, you said it's according to the power that worketh on the inside of us. So Father God, we just ask by the power of your Holy Spirit that you would take hold of these sacraments. Lord God, change them from a common to a spiritual. That, Lord God, when we partake of the bread, Lord God, we understand that it was your body, Jesus, that was broken for us, and it was for the healing of a nation. The nation, amen, all nations, amen. And we partake of the cup, the wine, the blood, the juice, Lord God. The blood that you said that is for the forgiveness of our sins, Lord God, and that you would wash them away by the power of the Holy Ghost and by the death, burial, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus Christ. So, Lord God, we humble ourselves today. Forgive us for all our transgressions and trespasses. Lord God, forgive us by omission and commission. Lord God, those things, we repent unto you today that we might have a great start on this afternoon, Lord God. So, Lord God, take hold of it now and then use us after the fact, that we might be able to please you in your sight. This is our prayer we place on your altar of grace and mercy. It's in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we do pray. And we all shout in agreement, amen, 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 and amen. Amen. And as they were at the table, the 12, and Jesus in the middle, he stood up in the midst of them and told them to break it. Take and eat. For this is my body that was broken for you. May we eat together. And he partook of the cup of the New Testament. He said, this is my blood. He said, drink ye all of it. May we drink together. He says, as often as you do eat of the bread and do drink of the cup, you do show the Lord's death until he cometh. And they went out singing a song from the Mount of Olives. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood.
For me.
One day then I was lost. Jesus died on the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. He never said a mumbling word. He never said a mumbling word. He never said a mumbling word.
For me.
Oh, one day when I was lost, Jesus died on the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. He hung his head and died. He hung his head and died. He hung his head and died.
For me.
One day when I was lost, One day when I was lost. Yeah. One day when I was lost. One day when I was lost. He died on the cross. And I know it was the blood. Tell me.
Yes. Hey.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Me and you. Amen. He got up for me and you. And it was his sanctified blood, that divine blood that saved us. Hey, and brought us across. Amen. Brought us over to Jordan. We ought to be shouting.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
To his name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me get out of here.
Glory to God.
Hey, Larry.
Yeah.
He only sang because I said I couldn't sing. He just wanted to rough it. Hear me, Larry. And then Vi jumped in with me. Yeah, Vi jumped in. Hey, I'm talking now, son. You can sing. Hey, then Vi jumped in with him. Then Monette threw her little voice in there.
I was trying to help him out.
Thank you for your help. Amen.
Amen.
I do the Bible. Carol, I make only joyful noise unto the Lord.
You did good. You did good.
Some people noise ain't joyful. That was
joyful. You was on key. You on key at least.
Hey.
Thank you.
I ain't never heard nobody replay that one part three times.
One day when I was lost. One day when I was lost. One day when I was lost. Hey, one day when I was lost. One day when I was lost. Come on, y'all think about it.
Come on. Hey, and we did the birthday song. Nobody, that ain't how you do it. Now when we go to another church, they try to sing it. That ain't how you do it.
You
know how to do it, Mick. Mick gonna get us put out the fellowship.
Oh, Mick had church by himself. He ain't studying, y'all.
Yeah, he was remembering.
Hey,
while I was yet,
you know we were talking a time ago. When you preach and sing, you ain't doing it to come back now.
I know it's right.
You ain't to come back now.
Hey, amen. But you can always come back to freedom. That's what I love. You're always welcome back.
Always.
When you can't, go nowhere else, freedom say, come on back in.
You gotta be able to go home.
Amen. Be who you are. Amen. So, amen. So anyway, we know we got the bling tonight. Testimony. My spiritual mother is well and actually got up, did her garden yesterday. Amen. She got up, did her garden. So she got her appetite back. She's eating. So that means she'll be fired, ready to rock tonight. And then Apostle's daughters are back home. They got back last night. And even Apostle Brokenborough was clear this morning.
All right.
Go back out now. But I had to tell him, he told me I'm ready to go ride 10 miles. And he said, well, maybe I shouldn't do that. I said, no, ain't no maybe. You don't need to be going out your first day, do 10 miles.
So
pray that our apostle flow in wisdom today. Amen.
Yeah.
And get out the flesh.
Amen.
Because I know him. I said, you ain't got to get it all back. Hey, this race ain't for the swift or the strong.
Amen.
So we need you to endure, Daddy. So after I talk to him, I think he's going to use some common sense. Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I pray after 4 miles, the chain just lock up.
Help him, Lord.
I told him. I tell him. That's my man. Hey, but we love everybody. Did we pray over the offer? Did we pray over the offer? Oh, shoot. Well. Amen. We took the offering, but hey, let's pray over it. We got all fired up and we got stuck on the song. What was the part we got stuck?
One day when I was lost.
Come on, y'all. One day when I was lost.
You almost get stuck on that.
One year when I was lost. 10 years.
Ooh, Jesus.
Years. How many of us lost? I was lost for 30 something years.
I was messed up.
Hey.
I didn't meet Jesus until I was 30 something. Right?
I'm a mighty long way.
Amen. So when he got stuck on one, I should say, go ahead 27 more times. I was lost for 30 years.
Come on.
Anybody know what I'm talking about? But now I'm found.
Sir,
that's why I don't let nobody tell you it don't take all that. You don't know the hell we've been through to get to where we are now. You don't know my story. Come on. You don't know what my Jesus did for me when nobody else was around. When everybody else turned back. Can I preach again? Everybody else.
Somebody.
You don't know what's in my alabaster box.
Go ahead, Carolyn.
You don't know the cost of my
Go ahead, Carolyn. Your turn. Preach. Say something. You don't go through the little pain. Say something. Go ahead.
Something.
All right, Vi, your turn, Vi. Give me something, Vi. Give me something.
Well, my word is I'm on my road of success. My road of success.
That's it.
That's the word. And that's what he gave me this morning.
All right.
All my kids on today. He spoke. He said, the road of success begins today. Right. May 22nd, 2021. 2021. We won. We are winners.
Amen.
On a road to success.
Amen.
And your word, Dad, was all up in it.
Yes.
So I was getting a word about my success road. So stay tuned. It's coming forth. Success road. My success road.
Yes, that's all right. You got to preach that one. We want to hear that preach.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
Your turn, Hope. What God's saying to you? What's going on? Give us a sermon, something quick, like give us some hope.
Well, just the Lord this week is just telling me to persevere, like what you were saying today, and just keep on pressing forward. Don't worry about your speed bumps and continue to press on and just keep your focus on the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
How you gonna have a name say and don't say nothing? Say something.
One word, awake.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, man.
Stay awake.
Sister Betty, you want to add to your testimony? I mean, if you don't say nothing else, you said a mouthful, but
amen.
I'm going to give you the screen.
Well, we have to. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. To pass the test, you must endure the test. Because you're in the fire. And when you go in the fire, God's in the fire with you, but he's taken the impurity out of our lives. So we will come forth as beautiful diamonds at the end.
And
we will get a reward when we go to heaven. Our crowns will be full of jewels. So keep trusting the Lord and obeying. Keep showing love, keep planting seeds, keep winning souls for the Lord, because the end time is coming soon. Yeah. He that wins souls is very wise. So be a soul winner for the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Before we go to the new swans and the old duck, I'm going to come to Mick for the third or fourth time, because me and Mick don't probably got to preach on 10 times a day, but I'm going to give Mick one more opportunity. Amen. That boy on fire, y'all. Hey, y'all see?
Wait,
hold on, my wife. Hold on, we ain't going to Pastor Cordy yet. Hold on. Let's go to Pastor Cordy real quick.
Well, the one thing in my mind as you were preaching today, there's a song from the 80s by a group called D-Train. Remember, it's called Keep On? But in part of the song, he says, if you have a goal, set it in your mind. Reach for it and say to yourself, this will be mine. So that's kind of what's been going on in my head. Set that goal in your mind. Reach for it.
Tell me.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Oh, look at Sam.
He
woke up.
My siblings. Now the cleanup song. There's something going on. Tell me.
I don't know what y'all doing up there in York, but that boy woke up, not on the word.
Man, he's woke. Come on now.
Don't woke him, let him slip.
Don't woke him, let him slip.
All right. Reverend Upshur, you got any last words? Song, inspiration?
No, I don't say no song, no, none of that. But I will say this, my encouraging words to you, stay in the race. Hold on and don't let go.
Amen.
That's what my I say to myself every day. Those are my words of encouragement to myself.
All right.
Stay in the race.
Yeah.
Hold on. Don't let go.
Amen.
God got a mighty blessing for you.
Amen.
Now, there are old song that you used to sing that could sum up all this stuff today. What's old? I know you got one.
Oh, okay. The one by the what do they call it? Sounds of blackness.
Blackness. Yeah.
Hold on, your change is coming.
Oh yeah.
Hold on. Don't you worry about a thing.
Hold on.
One day, just sing it. One day, just play it. Hold your on, change is coming. Hold on.
Hold
Everything's
on.
Gonna be all right.
Everything's gonna be all right. Yes. Yes.
Okay, I guess Monette and Larry know it's their turn now, because while you were talking, she was singing. So we're going to now turn it
on. Hold on.
Hey, remember this, Monette? Somebody talking, y'all cut them off. Just cut somebody off.
I was joining in.
And you already admit, because you was driving. She cut you off, ran you off. To,
I was joining in.
Remember that?
Jumping on the train.
Remember that from Wellsport and the other place, Scranton?
Yeah, we used to go,
Somebody start talking, they get cut off.
That's the Gap Band.
And all right, Larry Monette closes out. Any words y'all want to give before we just get up out of here?
Well, I just want to say, I love how you said you can't confuse the not now with not ever.
Ever, yes.
Amen. You can't confuse the not now with not ever. And we've got to persevere through the process. Trust the process. Yes. Amen. Yes. And so my mind has been on the bling, and Sister Betty kind of touched on it, that process that you go through, that diamond even goes through. That gold goes through, precious metals, precious things go through a process.
Yes.
We are precious in his sight. Right. Amen. And we're going through a process. So trust the process. You'll come out like pure gold. You'll come out blinging. Amen. Blinging for Christ.
Amen.
All right, Pastor Larry, everybody's talking tonight. Say something. Even if you say, what's up, Blackie, the dog in Haiti.
No, I've just been meditating on representing Christ to the people.
All right.
It's just representing Christ. Whoever I come in contact with, I just want to be a good representation of who Christ is.
Amen. Amen.
So I just encourage us to keep that focus, you know, because so many things come at us in so many ways, so many different times in a day. Different people they're going through so many things, but no matter what they throw at you, I want to represent Christ.
All right.
Amen.
Well, with that being said, this concludes our service. Amen. Amen. We're now going to turn it over to the undertaker.
What?
Who are you? We are now going to turn the service over to say, can you close out in prayer?
You can call, say, the undertaker.
Is it
wrestling?
Yeah, Undertaker's closed service.
Can't hear you.
That ain't the first time you said that about me, too. That's twice.
Uh-oh.
Pray for him.
I love that man. Y'all knew that. That's my brother. I never had him.
Bless your heart, Pastor Cordy. Heavenly Father, we just glorify your name and just thank you today, Lord. And we pray that you keep us in truth and spirit.
Yes.
That each and every day that you give us, Lord, that we wake up with the will to transform and be a good servant. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, amen. We got to let y'all go. The anointing has lifted. My wife said,
uh-oh, let me shut it down.
You may commit the body. No, I'm just kidding.
That's right. We dying to ourselves.
We need to die daily. Hey.
Dying daily. Undertaker.
Daily. We got to be dead man walking.
Dead man walking.
Here come another servant. Everybody want to know now. Hey.
I see dead people.
Monette, yes. You are the funeral director. Let's kill this service. Come on.
All right. I see dead people.